As California's in the midst of another drought, the reservoir levels are pretty critical. Live Copter 3 was over Folsom Lake earlier today, and right now it is at 62% of capacity. Here's a look at some of our other reservoirs. Lake Oroville is at 48% of capacity, and Shasta Lake is at 38%. When planning for water shortages in California, water managers need all the information they can get. KCRA3's meteorologist Heather Waldman shows us the new research from NASA that's now adding some insights for the state's agriculture regions.
During periods of drought, up to 80% of the water used in California's agriculture sector is pumped from underground aquifers. That groundwater is vital in supporting such a huge part of the state's economy and a huge part of the U.S. food supply. But too much pumping can lead to subsidence, where basically the land starts sinking.
And this is a problem on two different fronts. It's going to damage infrastructure, and it's going to have land subsidence on the surface. And then you're also decreasing the storage space you could have for groundwater.
Long-term trends show significant subsidence in parts of the Central Valley. If that continues on, groundwater storage space will shrivel away. That's part of why lawmakers passed the Sustainable Groundwater Management Act in 2014. But short-term changes in the aquifer can give key insights into the effects of groundwater pumping, too. That's what a team of researchers at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory have been working on.
Okay, now we have a framework where we could utilize different satellite products and then understand the changes better for that region. The groundwater could be decreasing in terms of the water table, but we could actually have changes in the land surface that could be asynchronous or moving in an opposite direction.
California's Department of Water Resources is also utilizing aircraft equipped with special sensors to get a close-up look at current aquifer conditions. Insights from all of this research can help water managers understand the severity of groundwater loss, allowing them to better predict shortages in the months and years ahead. I'm meteorologist Heather Waldman for KCRA 3 News.